I've rerouted power to the launch security systems. We're clear to commence today's operation. Gain access to the facility and secure the launch codes.
One snag. Looks like the Hive have sealed the bunker entrance we used last time. Head to the launch facility group. We should be able to make an entrance up there. Blast it off and head in.
You
changes to the underlying system architecture. I've secured the launch authorization codes, but it appears they are encrypted. This encryption method is superb. I will need time to fully decrypt them. Any launch will need to wait.
Got it. In the meantime, I'll ping some of the old decommissioned bunkers here to cover our tracks, because I just got word that there's a catch inbound. We don't want to still be here when it lands.
First fragments are bonding to Red's code nicely. Our plan's risky, but I'll be damned. Clovis wasn't lying. When I first woke up, I wasn't lost. I was wayward in the best way. Just my ghost and a name on a badge. I imagined us Brays using reason to find right. Lone lights exploring the vast frontier, you know? I was proud of that fantasy. I modeled myself after it. Fantasies. All it was, obviously. I mean, you've met Clovis. He's a walking, talking embodiment of necessary evil. I miss Risk being a dark cave in the wilderness. Danger? Or Golden Age tech? Balancing that tipping point was straightforward. Now it's less defined. And Risk is measured in the inches before Clovis's knife finds my back. I know it's coming, eventually. But if it means getting Red back, I'll manage the risk.
Not only did Rasputin change the launch codes, but it encrypted the new ones as well. Impressive. One can never be too cautious when keeping secrets. Some information is far too dangerous to remain freely accessible. I've hidden many things from my family, for their own sake. I can appreciate Rasputin's decision to do so as well. But that does not change our objective. We must wrest control of the Warsats for the good of humanity. I will begin decrypting the launch codes to the orbital station. Continue gathering submine data and reintegrating it into the Engram. When the time comes, Rasputin will be made to listen to us, regardless of the secrets it keeps.
She doesn't listen. I try to get through to her, show her the logical consequences of her choices. Then she digs her heels in, and the more I push, the harder she pushes back, even when she knows she's wrong.
Siblings, hmm?
Oh, sorry. I shouldn't have thrown all that on you.
How long have we known each other, Elsie?
It's hard to really say. With how many times we've been down this road, it feels like forever. But I think years. Years.
And in all that time, I've only known you as a dedicated sister. Anna's known you for far less. You remember your childhood, the bonds you formed, the trust you built together. She doesn't have that. Anna can't understand the depth of your love or the guilt you carry for your missteps. All she knows is what's in front of her, and that kills you, little by little. You gaze at her and a ghost gazes back, a ghost you desperately want to save.
That's the point, isn't it?
You have to let people choose for themselves. Or you risk driving them down an even darker path than the one you want to steer them from. And we both know how that ends.